can see here, you know, they're in the 50s, kind of 60 range. So everyone would benefit from working on these particular areas. Which is, you know, the reason why I wrote the grant to get the instructional material was because I wanted to incorporate that aspect into it. We're going to just look at persisters. The 1 year of persistence rate for this population, and what we see is that 25% of the group did not persist, whereas 68%. We had some missing cases of that 930 because students didn't complete the entire instrument. And so, and by the way, let me just say that as I was looking through the data, I noticed that students were leaving us even with good GPAs. This is one of the other areas that I want to look at next. Why were students not retained even if they had a good GPA? So we're going to look at that in the near future. Going back to the skill will components, the components of the skill are broken down into these particular areas: information processing, selecting main ideas, and test taking strategies. And you can see that there is, by the way, what we did is just a simple t-test of means. I'm going to utilize a more sophisticated statistical analysis in the near future. But just looking at the means distribution, and you can see that there are differences between persistence and non-persistence for these components. You can see also for those within the will component, attitude, anxiety, and motivation, you can also see that there are differences in means. Again, we'll see if they are significant or not. And then finally, within the self-regulation component, time management, self-testing, and concentration, you could also see that there is a difference in the means for the persisters and the non-persisters. Question is, are these significant? So of the total students who completed the study, 638 students were first-year persisters, 234 were not persisters. With exception to the attitude scale, persisters scored significantly higher than non-persisters on all other nine scales: anxiety, concentration, information processing, motivation, and so on. Some of these were to the significance level of a 0.001. The two that were at the 0.001 were the anxiety and the concentration, which makes sense, right? I mean, if the anxiety is too high, it makes it difficult to focus and concentrate. So that tells me, as a counselor, as an instructor, that I need to be more explicit with my students, more structured, clearer, so that there is no misunderstanding about what my expectations are, in order to cause them, any kind of distress, frustration. So those are the numbers, basically significance of 9 except for attitude. These are the recommendations to develop a freshman orientation course utilizing the LASSI as a diagnostic and prescriptive assessment tool, which is what I'm doing. I have the instruction material incorporated into the course. Use the LASSI's instructional material to develop lesson plans and assignments in order to achieve better learning outcomes. Once again, that's what I'm doing at the present. Develop learning communities utilizing the LASSI to coordinate instruction, collaboration, and service around students' needs. That is a wish. I mean, I've worked in learning communities, but I think we need to develop more learning communities around, you know, these kind of goals and aims and learning outcomes that we're trying to achieve. I envision, for example, a learning community with, you know, a counselor like myself, say somebody who teaches psychology, and the other somebody who's teaching English, and we work together around the LASSI, picking the LASSI, and look at what each particular instructor, what piece do they want to play, and to collaborate. Utilize LASSI data to inform counselors with respect to the student's personal and academic needs and interests. It is believed that the LASSI, as well as other instruments, by the way, like Myers-Briggs Focus 2, Noah Levitz is another one that we use, provide students with opportunities to gain, share information and insights regarding their personality, their needs, interests, and goals. So you can have that conversation. And develop workshops and audiovisual material for students related to the topics covered by the LASSI. So far, you know, we have the workshop, but I'd like to, for us to develop some audiovisual material also. I think some students would do better with that than just reading, and, you know, all the time. Okay.
Yeah, I have some questions.
Yes.
Waiting for that moment.
Yes.
Very good presentation, very interesting and very, that's a topic that we worry about in national, as the president of National University College, but we have the same issue that we have. And we've been looking for an instrument to kind of access the prospective side of it. How would these students success? Is this student capable of success? Should we invest in this student? What we should do with them? My question is, you said it's validated. I imagine it's in the general population of the United States. It's not validated for Hispanics, it's not in Spanish.
No.
So that's validation.
Yeah, so that's
raise a problem with the cultural part of it, which I think is the most important part of it.
Yes.
How those cultural characteristics that we have, let's say the Puerto Rican, for us, time is a very different concept. As the North American have. For us, time, you know, you live in an island, the personality our personality affects how we behave and how we study and how we see the other culture. So I think that's something that we would like to study. It's something that we need to study. So the validation part of it worries me a little bit because I think it affects the results. And also, I would like to know if you have any data, any comparison between those results and the regular population, which is out of those economies. Are those results very different from the general population of students in the university that are not taking those courses or that instrument?
Yeah, for the general population, you're talking about the broader general population?
Yeah, because the retention, for us, with the persistence of the retention of the first generation, our average is 70% without that much help. So I would like to see if there is any comparison between those students we're dealing with and the other students that are kind of groups.
Like the students I work with versus, say, students at Lehman. That kind of population or senior college population?
Students that are not in this study.
Yes,
okay.
So a comparable population of community college students, say in Nebraska.
But I think he's talking about just your own
college.
In the college. A comparable number. I haven't done that comparison to say, for example, the students that I'm working with versus students that my colleagues are working with. That type of comparison? Yeah. You know, I do have enough data so I can look at that and make a comparison. So I have, for example, a colleague of mine this semester who gave that instrument to his class. So I can look at that, but, you know.
Without giving the
lesson. I see. Okay. No, not
that. Yeah, because I've been seeing that a counselor, a psychologist, mm-hmm. which is teaching the university preparation course that we have, are better. The results are better than the other ones.
Right, I see.
Just because you deal with the behavior, with the emotional part of it, you are prepared for that.
Right.
Because if I have another person preparing science or in arts, or the approach is different.
I see.
So just for being a counselor,
right.
that is affecting your results.
Yes, yes, yes.
Just your preparation.
Yes.
Because you are prepared to deal with that.
Yes.
And right. I think this is so important for those students to be success that I don't like those courses. I would like to see that included in every course that the student take. Mm-hmm. Reading skills, thinking skills, critical thinking skills should be everywhere, not only in these preparation courses.
Right, right,
so
exactly.
So I've been fighting with that courses I started in the university because it's, you know, some faculty and some students think this is the preparation course. I discussed this here, but I don't need it anymore for my other courses.
Mm-hmm.
So, and we need that for life.
Yes.
So it should be part of the curriculum.
I will look, I definitely will look into that. I mean, to do it, it's like kind of a comparison. Yes, as I move forward. Yes, as a control.
Yeah.
As a control. Yeah, okay. Well, thanks for that. Yeah, because the challenges are there. I mean, the challenges are there. And I find that, you know, the students that we work with, my colleagues, at least, you know, my colleagues and I, you know, when we get together at our meetings, you know, we pretty much work with the same kind of population. To say get another student who has not had that kind of support, and it's not going to be too hard to find. Because just last semester, we had close to 600 students who decided not to take any orientation, whether it was the seminar or the orientation. You see, that?
¿Te hablo español?
Sí.
Eso es una diferencia.
Sí, sí, sí.
No es lo mismo un profesor que habla español
Exacto.
que uno que no habla español, mm-hmm. dando el mismo curso. O sea, que hay unas variables interesantes con esta población de hispanos, ¿verdad? Que nosotros
I'm going to definitely look into that. Thank you. Any other questions? Yeah.
Do you know if that instrument allows for you to make a wider implementation of the instrument with your system? Because as you were saying, and seeing that it would benefit only for those students that are being within that intervention, but.
Right.
How come this system allows to provide this instrument to all students to go and take? Like, as I start my education, how can I go see what my strengths are, my learning styles are, and from there, perhaps doing interventions the second semester, the first year, and then seeing how being the institution implemented. I know other tools, they provide you as how you do it. You ask the students to go and take the test. So you have the burden to do all the processing, to get all that information and then make it sensible.
Right.
But if those instruments allow for that to be integrated within your current student systems,
mm-hmm.
then students will be able to get, and then you as an institution will be able to have a bigger picture of how these instruments are, how your students come to your school, and then from there create interventions.
Yeah, I mean, it takes an institutional commitment.
Yeah.
And that is something that even I've seen some successful programs not achieve that kind of priority. You know, my colleague who worked with this program that he developed with his colleagues. They developed a very successful program, but I saw that with time, they just didn't continue. The institutions decided not to continue. I don't understand that, but again, I think now, historically, the focus has shifted from enrollment to retention, And I think people are going to have to start, institutions are going to start to pay closer attention to retention, because it's more expensive to enroll than it is to retain. So it makes sense on all levels. And I am happy that this day has finally arrived, because now I think that institution will be more amenable to incorporating this systematically for all students, not just a select group who is in a special program, or those who happen to stumble and on a course like a seminar and decide that it's important. Unfortunately, some students are getting mixed messages about these types of courses to their own detriment. Because we know that even if you are a good student and you're academically prepared, we know that you're going to face challenges.
Well, the important for the emotional intelligence, the whole social and emotional learning,
yes,
which is getting bigger attention. If you give to the faculty, to all the faculty, that instrument, you'd like to see the results.
Yes.
To the faculty.
Right.
Because I do that with some of my employees. We use another instrument. Hmm. But just to tell them, this is your profile.
Right.
Profile, and this is the profile of our students. Sometimes it won't match.
Right.
So you have to decide either you change or you leave, because
right,
these are our students.
And that's the thing.
So it will be very interesting to see how it
is. Well, I will continue because I'm committed to it. And so I also want to thank you all for coming. Question?
Yeah, I'm going to have a question. Cost. What is the instrument cost? I know it's online. What about training? I mean, you happen to have a clinical background, and you mentioned earlier that there are now four full-time counselors. You know, what about the training piece for those that are interpreting the instrument? What can you say anything about that?
Yeah, I believe the cost is $5 per administration for the LASSI. I've got what the order form with me, so I can show you. That is. Insofar as the training is concerned, basically someone, generally with, I would say, psychology or counseling background, and I've even known counselors that don't have such a background who are committed to student success, learn how to utilize this information effectively. So you can even train peers to do this, by the way. I think you could train peers to do this. Basically, what you want is somebody who is well-versed at what it takes to succeed academically and otherwise. And a good student who's been through might even be more effective than even a faculty member who is disinterested. Some just feel that remediation shouldn't be a part of the university process, and so what are we doing? That's pretty much it. Thank you so much once again.
Thank you.